If the drawers are pulled out of the bedroom chest, and you can't find one of your winter vests, or after supper, one of the girls suddenly misses her Woolworth pearls. Then the family will say, it's that horrible cat. Was it Mungo Jerry?
Or Rumpelteazer?
And most of the time, they'll leave it at that. Mungo Jerry and Rumpelteazer have an unusual gift of the gab. We are highly efficient cat burglars as well.
And remarkably smart at a smash and grab.
We make our home in Victoria Grove. We have no regular occupation. We are plausible fellows who like to engage a friendly policeman in conversation.
Oh, when the family assembles for Sunday dinner, their minds made up that they wouldn't get cleaner. An Argentine joint, potatoes and greens, then the cook will appear from behind the scenes
and say in a voice that is broken with sorrow, I'm afraid Mungo Jerry
or Rumpelteazer.
And most of the time they leave it at that.
Mungo Jerry and Rumpelteazer have a wonderful way of letting it together. And some of the time they would say it was luck. And some of the time they would say it was weather. They go through the house like a hurricane, and no sooner mercy the day is over.
Was it Mungo
criminal who can defy the law. He's the bafflement of Scotland Yard, the flying squad's despair. For when they reach the scene of crime, Macavity's not there.
Macavity's a ginger cat. He's very tall and thin. You'd Know him, you saw him, for his eyes are sunken in. His brow is deeply lined with thought, his head is highly domed. His coat is dusty from neglect, his whiskers are uncombed. He sways his head from side to side with movements like a snake. And when you think he's half asleep, he's always wide awake. Macavity, Macavity, there's no one like Macavity. He's a feeling like shit, a monster of depravity. You may meet him in a by street, you may see him in the square. But when a crime's discovered, then Macavity's not there. He's outwardly respectable. I know he cheats at cards, and his footprints are not found in any files of Scotland Yard. And when the lauder's looted, or the jewel case is rifled, or when the milk is missing, or another peach's been stifled, or the greenhouse glass is broken, and the trellis past repair, there's the wonder of the thing. Macavity's not there. Macavity, Macavity. The deed took place, Macavity wasn't there. And they say that all the cats whose wicked deeds are widely known, I might mention Mungo Jerry, I might mention Griddlebone, are nothing more than agents for the cat who all the time just controls the operations, the Napoleon of crime.
Oh, American ways are a matter of habit. Oh, if you offer a fish, then I always want a feast. There isn't any fish that I won't eat, rabbit. You offer me cream, then I sniff and sniff. I only like what I find for myself. Nope! So you catch me in it right under my ears and you put it away. Original conjuring cat. There can be no doubt about that. Please, listen to me. And don't scoff. All his inventions are off his own bat. There's no such cat in the metropolis. He holds all the patent monopolies for performing surprising illusions and creating eccentric confusions. The greatest magicians have something to learn from Mr. Mistopheles' conjuring turns. And you will all say, oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as magical Mr. Mistopheles. He's quiet, he's small, he's black. From his ears to the tip of his tail, he can creep through the tiniest crack. He can walk on the narrowest rail. He can pick any card from a pack. He's equally cunning with dice. He's always deceiving you into believing that he's only hunting for mice. He can play any trick with a cock or a spoon and a bit of fish paste. And if you look for a knife or a fork and you think it is merely misplaced, you'll see it one moment and then it is gone, but you'll find it next week lying out on the moon. And we all say, oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as a jigger, Mr. Mistopheles. Oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as a jigger, Mr. Mistopheles. His manner is vague and aloof. You would think there was nobody shyer, but his voice has been heard on the roof while he was curled up by the floor. fire. He sometimes been heard by the fire when he was about on the roof. At least they all heard that somebody purred, which is incontestable proof. Ow! Of his singular magical powers, I've known the family to call him in the garden for hours while he was asleep in the hall. And not long ago, this phenomenal cat produced 7 kittens right out of a hat. And we all say, oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as Magic Blue, Mr. Mr. Freeze. Oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as Magic Blue.
Street light.